What's up, all my plant lovers? Devin is here, ready for another episode of Plant Vibes TV with me, Devin Wallin. Today I'm super stoked talking about Heuchera, coral bells, sometimes alum root, depending on the species. Every kind of Heuchera species has a different common name or regional name. I just like to call them Heuchera or coral bells, is I think easy. Why am I so excited? Well, I'm in the shade here and you see all of this color. It's one of my favorite plants. You know, when I was first starting to garden, it was all about the flowers, 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 flowers. Foliage was green and it was there and it was whatever. Well, then I started to realize, okay, foliage with color, now that is something special, because as the old saying goes, I don't know if who said it or if I made it up, you know, flowers are for a day but foliage is for all seasons, something like that. And when it comes to coral bells, Heuchera, let me just show you, these are just such beautiful plants. Many of them are evergreen or semi-evergreen depending on where you live. Look at that, you know, you got that silvery tinges. This is called the Indian Summers Heuchera, mulberry, and then we have this lime colored one. And so this video is just going to be all about Heuchera, all about the coral bells. And so there's a few different species of coral bells out there. Typically, you go to your garden centers, there's a million different coral bells. So it's really hard to actually know what to pick. Really, when it comes down to it, just pick one that you like. If it has cool foliage and you like that color, that's the one that you should be picking. I typically go for the ones that are called the villosa hybrids. Heuchera villosa is the species, and hybrids are basically, it's a hybrid of the villosa, maybe bred with another species, but I find the villosa hybrids tend to be the most tolerant of heat conditions. And I live here in eastern Pennsylvania, just outside of Philadelphia, zone 6B to be exact. And so we get really hot summers. Typically coral bells, Heuchera, they do great from zones 4 to 9 thereabouts. I've heard stories of them doing well down in Florida, Texas, I haven't seen it, or like really far north. But you know, Heuchera, it's a native to North America. Typically native to areas with like woodland, you can imagine a woodland setting on maybe like a bank or you know, something like that where the drainage is great. Probably there's a ready supply of moisture from the rain, moist, rich soil. Those are sort of the conditions that Heuchera really need. So if you can sort of kind of envision those in your minds while you're planting, while you're deciding where to put your Heuchera, that can be very helpful. Now in my garden, I've experimented growing these in all different areas and I've learned a few things. I had some planted under, this is a beautiful deciduous metasequoia. I had planted some under there, and right behind it is a river birch, that guy. So it's, I thought, you know, it'd be nice and shady location. Turns out it was too close to the tree roots and it basically sucked up any extra moisture, and after a few months it kind of just disappeared. No problem. I found that this area has been an absolute delightful area. The soil is very rich. This is kind of a vintage flower bed from, you know, this has been here since the 50s. So it has really nice rich soil. You can see I'm in the shade. It's about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. It gets about 3, maybe 4 hours of morning sunlight, and that's really and truly all that it needs. You can plant them in more sunlight, but you'll need to be out there watering. And like I'm telling you, I don't water plants in my garden out here. I go by the survival, you know, they survive and thrive or they die away. That's kind of my motto. I don't have time to be out watering, too busy doing other things. So I plant stuff where I think it's gonna do well. And if it does do well without any watering, then I got a winner. And if it doesn't, then it's okay. I work with plants, so I have an unlimited amount of plants that I can get. But that's kind of the purpose of these videos, is to relay what I've learned in my experiences. So if you do have kind of a watering system and you wanna put these in a more full sunny location, great, go ahead. Give them that extra rain, give them that extra water. But here for me in this conditions with, you know, early morning sunlight, the rainfall will be more than enough to keep these happy. And it has been. You can see they're doing really well. Now, the thing is, these plants, they're considered evergreen or semi-evergreen, depending on where you live. If you live quite far north, they will definitely get, you know, probably lose their foliage in the wintertime. But on the flip side, if you live in the really warm areas of the country or of the world, they will definitely get a little bit tattered in the summertime, which is a good opportunity to give them a full chop back, cut them back if they're starting to look a little bit tattered, a little bit long in the tooth, and that's gonna allow them to regenerate for the fall and early winter. Their peak seasons would be like springtime and like early and kind of late summer all the way till early winter when the temperatures are a little bit cooler. Definitely zones 5 to 7 are going to have the best looking Heuchera, I think. But I just absolutely love them. Now, one thing you should note is that they're not super long lived perennials. They're like an echinacea, maybe 4 or 5 years at most, but that doesn't mean that they're just gonna melt away and go away after that time. What you actually need to do is you need to go and divide it. So I want to show you guys real quick how to divide them. Now, for me here in Eastern Pennsylvania, it's like middle of April. It's a great time to go and plant. You can see I have a nice tray of Heuchera that I'm about to plant up to add in there. One quick side note, the darker colored varieties, the purples, the burgundies, I have some like caramel colored one. Let me see, where is this guy? I have this beautiful like caramely colored one. These ones are gonna be able to handle the sunlight better than our more lime colored ones. You can see this is kind of what it looks like when it starts to get a little bit tattered. Rip it off, rip this old foliage off. Just be, you know, a little bit rough with it, that's okay. These ones are gonna wanna be situated in more shade than their darker cousins, okay? When it comes to dividing, I'm gonna divide this one that's in this container. If you have plants in the ground, which you will, basically just dig out the entire plant. Just go around, just dig out around the edges of the entire plant. And they're very shallow rooted plants, so it's not gonna be hard to actually dig out. I think next summer, I will probably need to divide these from here. Right now, I don't need to yet, but I wanted to show you guys how easy it is to do it from these plants. Okay, so because they are so shallow rooted, it's really easy to dig them out. And then, let's see if I can get in close. So basically, you can see they start to form little clumps. Here you can see one clump here. Here you can see another clump there. Now, as they basically grow and mature, that initial central plant will die out and it will create that bald spot. So that's what we're actually going to be removing. You dig it out and then you have these clumps, these new formed clumps. Use your hands, use your shovel, whatever. And you honestly can just rip it apart just like this. Now you have brand new plants. You go and you plant this. You discard that central bald spot that wasn't really doing anything. That's kind of the key. And don't worry about manhandling these. It's okay. You know, these are really robust plants. They don't mind that. Another thing is because they are shallow rooted plants, easy to dig out, easy to plant back in as well. And they also generally don't fill out those nursery pots. So if you pull it out and some of that soil is left in the pot, that's okay. Just dump that soil out into your flower beds. Give it that little extra like espresso shot of soil. So I wanted to show you guys another thing that can happen in your garden with your Heuchera over the winter time. All right, so let's go check something out over behind me. Okay, so you can see this guy right here and this guy right here. The lighting's a little bit tough. I'm underneath a Japanese maple. You can see I'm underneath a Japanese maple, so the lighting's a little bit tough right now, but we'll try to show you guys anyway. So something called heaving can occur in the wintertime when the ground freezes. So, you know, you can imagine there's moisture in the ground, it freezes, and then when it thaws, it, you know, it creates more volume and it will actually push the crown of your Heuchera out of the ground. And it looks kind of weird, just like this. So it's like not really well in there at all. You basically just need to go dig a new hole and replant it in. But it is something to keep your eye on. Sometimes you can just kind of pack it back in with your hands just like this. It is something to keep your eye on because, you know, if it's exposing any roots, that's never good, as we know from Plant 101. So here you can see this beautiful Japanese maple. I'm gonna be planting it right down here along those edges. It's such a great plant for edging because it does remain in color all year long. I'm gonna plant it amongst these hellebores over here. They like very similar conditions to your hellebores. So if you have hellebores that are happy, these are a great addition. You can see just this beautiful patchwork of colors. So pretty. One of my favorite plants for the shade. So if you are wondering about flowers, typically the flowers are a little bit insignificant. It's really, the foliage is the show, but there are, I've had some new varieties out of Terra Nova. Terra Nova, Heuchera are some of the best, as well out of Walter's Gardens breeder, Hans Hansen. He makes some wonderful hybrids of Heuchera. So those are two different kind of brands to look out for when you're shopping for your Heuchera. And they do have some new varieties that have very beautiful showy flowers on top of gorgeous foliage. So you can get your cake and eat it too. Anyways, I hope you found this video a little bit informative and fun about one of my favorite plants for the shade, something I'm gonna be having, you know, all over my shady woodland garden out here in Eastern Pennsylvania. If you have any further questions or comments or you know, topics that you would like for me to talk about, make sure to subscribe, leave your comments below. I always try to answer them as well as I can. And yeah, every single Sunday we have longer form videos just like this, or about a plant topic that has, you know, been on my work agenda in my schedule. And I just kind of share my experiences as being a professional plant dude. Anyways, thanks for joining me here on Plant Vibes, Plant Vibrations. I'll catch you guys soon. Ciao.